Hey, what's up? Tristan from Huge Menace here. Welcome to part 7 of the Endy add-on deep dive series. In this video, we'll cover the deform operators. These operators, as the name would suggest, allow you to twist, bend, skew, and otherwise deform your geometry non-destructively. Let's get started. We'll use our good friend Suzanne for this video to mix things up a bit. The extra model details will help illustrate the different operators better than a cube or a simple shape would. The first operator we'll examine is simple deform. I'm starting with this one because the lattice operator is slightly more advanced, but we'll cover it later. With Suzanne selected, let's choose simple deform. The simple deform operator offers four different modes. The first by default is twist. The twist mode takes in the specified angle and twists the geometry around the given axis by that amount. The angle can range from negative 360 to positive 360 degrees. To change the axis, hit the A key. To switch to a different mode, hit the M key. I'll quickly go through each mode and adjust its corresponding angle or factor and the affected axis to give you an idea of what each one does. The simple deform operator is quite, well, simple, so there's not much more to say about it. Let's jump over to a more advanced deform method, the lattice operator. Once again, we'll use Suzanne as our demo model. With Suzanne selected, choose the lattice operator. This operator adds a new lattice cage to the scene and automatically sizes it to match the bounding box of your selected geometry. With that in place, you can begin by specifying the U, V, and W points or resolutions. The operator syncs these three by default, so adjusting them is uniform. However, if you'd like to be more specific, you can hit the U key to toggle uniform editing and specify the number of points independently. For now though, we'll stick with a uniform number of points. The last parameter you can change is the interpolation mode, which supports four algorithms: linear, cardinal, catmull-rom, and B-spline. These four algorithms change how the geometry tied to each vertex on the lattice cage changes with its transformation. We'll stick to linear as it's the most straightforward. Once applied, you'll be left with your original object and the new lattice cage which is selected. From here, applying any deformation happens inside of edit mode. Select the vertices of the lattice object closest to the parts of the target object you want to affect and move, translate, scale, or rotate them. That's all there is to know about the deform modifiers and ND. In the following video, we'll take a look at the simplify operators. I'll see you there.